Are we all sinners? If you talk with the average professing Christian in our dark day, they will answer without hesitation that not only are they themselves sinners, but everyone is a sinner. Folks, is that the truth or just another religious myth designed by the devil to deceive people into sin? Who is a sinner in the Bible? Is it possible to be a sinner and a Christian at the same time? Wasn't Paul the worst of all sinners? Let's look at God's Word to find answers. Question: is everyone a sinner according to the Bible? Answer: no. Clearly, not every person is a sinner. Only unsaved people are sinners. According to God's Word, one is either a sinner or a righteous person. Let me prove this to you. Jesus taught in Luke 15, verse 7, I tell you that in the same way there is more rejoicing in heaven over one sinner who repents than over 99 righteous persons who do not need to repent. Jesus taught there that one is either a sinner or a righteous person, and if you are a sinner, then you need to repent. So the next time someone identifies himself as a sinner in your presence, tell him he needs to repent, according to the Lord Jesus in Luke 15, 7. Also, did you notice that in Luke 15, 7, a righteous person is one who does not need to repent? Another time where it is clear that one is either a sinner or a righteous person is found in 1 Peter 4:18, which says, and if it's hard for the righteous to be saved, what will become of the ungodly and the sinner? There, Peter equates the ungodly and the term sinner and contrasts both of them to the righteous. In Luke 5:32, Jesus also taught, I have not come to call the righteous but sinners to repentance. And remember this truth, one must be righteous to enter God's kingdom and escape hell. In other words, all non-righteous people will be thrown into the fiery furnace. Jesus taught, once again, the kingdom of heaven is like a net that was let down into the lake and caught all kinds of fish. When it was full, the fishermen pulled it up on the shore. Then he sat down and collected the good fish in baskets, but threw the bad away. This is how it will be at the end of the age. The angels will come and separate the wicked from the righteous and throw them into the fiery furnace where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth, Matthew 13, 47 through 50. Jesus taught there that one is either wicked or righteous, and if one is not righteous, he will be thrown into the fiery furnace. In light of all these scriptures, not everyone is a sinner. Righteous people are not sinners. Only people headed for the fiery furnace are sinners, and they need to repent. Now let me give you some additional truth about the people who are sinners. Paul wrote in Romans 5:8, but God demonstrates his own love for us in this, that while we're still sinners, Christ died for us. One is always a sinner and hellbound before he becomes a Bible-defined Christian. And if he never gets biblically saved, he will always be a Bible-defined sinner, regardless how many religious things he will do. But that's not all. According to the Bible, one can become a sinner again after becoming a Christian. The Bible says this, my brethren, if any among you strays from the truth and one turns it back, let him know that he who turns a sinner from the error of his way will save his soul from death and will cover a multitude of sins. James 5, 19 and 20. According to that passage, a Christian, that is one in the truth, can afterwards stray from the truth and become a sinner again. And while he would be in such a spiritual condition, his soul would be lost and headed for eternal death. But even then, he could turn and go back to where he was before he strayed, that is, back to the truth, and he will find forgiveness and spiritual life. This proves, among other things, that one can get saved more than once, which is also found in Luke 15:24 and Romans 11:19-23. But in James 5:19-20, a sinner is one who was once a Christian but since died spiritually. All of this helps us to know who the sinners are. By the way, since there are different degrees of sin, not all sin will lead a Christian to spiritual death. Hence, sins that do not lead to death, if committed, will not make a Christian a sinner. 1 John 5:16 and 17 speaks of sins that lead to death and sin that does not lead to death. You might be wondering, If it is impossible to be a sinner and a Christian at the same time, then what about 1 Timothy 1:15, where Paul wrote this about himself? Here's a trustworthy saying that deserves full acceptance. Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am the worst. Paul was referring to his life before conversion. This becomes apparent when you examine the immediate context, which starts at verse 13. Let's read that again, but this time starting at verse 13. Even though I was once a blasphemer and a persecutor and a violent man, I was shown mercy because I acted in ignorance and unbelief. The grace of our Lord was poured out on me abundantly, along with the faith and love that are in Christ Jesus. Here's a trustworthy saying that deserves full acceptance. Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am the worst. 1 Timothy 1:13 through 15. Again, Paul was referring to his life before he became a Christian, when he persecuted the saints. That is why he said he is the worst of sinners. If that meant Paul the Apostle was the worst sinner of all time, that is, worse than Judas Iscariot, a serial murderer, a child molester, etc., then basically the whole New Testament after Acts chapter 9 would contradict that ludicrous concept. Strange as it may sound, the eternal security proponents want people to believe Paul, as a Christian, was the worst of all sinners. They want people to think you have to sin all the time. No one can obey God. Even the Apostle Paul didn't obey God, which would make their own sinful lives more acceptable to their Christian profession. The truth is, when Paul wrote 1 Timothy 1:15, Paul was not a sinner, but something vitally different. Also recorded in 1 Timothy chapter 1, Paul clearly described himself as a holy and obedient man of God. With these words, Paul issued a command, then wrote this. The goal of this command is love, which comes from a pure heart, a good conscience, and a sincere faith. Some have wandered away from these and turned to meaningless talk. 1 Timothy 1:5 and 6. Paul said he had a pure heart, a good conscience, and a sincere faith, which would be impossible if Paul was the worst sinner that ever lived, worse than Judas Iscariot, a child molester, a serial killer, etc. In conclusion, a sinner, according to the Bible, is always an unsaved person who needs to repent. A person is a sinner if he was never saved, or if he lost his salvation and is still spiritually dead. It is therefore a sign of gross ignorance of the Bible to refer to a Christian as a sinner, and especially if one thinks Paul was the worst sinner of all times. A Christian is a righteous person or obedient person, and it is only such people who will enter God's kingdom in the end. Remember, Jesus is the author of eternal salvation, but only for those who obey Him. Hebrews 5:9. God bless you.
Today is the day of salvation. Right now, you are determining where you will go after death, either to the lake of fire or to a paradise heaven.